Hi guys, welcome to Gatematic. In the previous lecture, we saw the concept of multiple PWM technique in which I derived the Fourier series expression of multiple PWM technique, and based on that, I derived the Fourier series expression of single PWM. Okay. Now in this lecture, we will start one of the most important topic of inverter, that is the Fourier series expression of unequal PWM. I divided this lecture in three part. Part A contains the introduction of Fourier series in PWM technique. Part B contains the control of output voltage just by seeing the waveform and writing the Fourier series expression. And part C contains how to reduce the harmonic, that is the selective harmonic elimination. That is very important from gate point of view, also from interview point of view. That is the selective harmonic elimination. So these all things we are going to see in the coming three lectures. So please guys, do not skip any lecture from now. In this lecture, I will start introduction to Fourier series in PWM. Most of the students are having a fear of Fourier series. Watch this lecture. At the end, you will came to know that Fourier series is an easiest way to represent any kind of periodic function. So let's get started. I noted down some of the important formula in order to reduce the time of this lecture. So let us define the Fourier series. Why we are finding the Fourier series? We know any periodic waveform can be resolved in the series of sine as well as cosine component. That is what Fourier series do. It can be represented in series of DC as well as sine and cosine component having different harmonic, where n is the number of harmonic. Okay, so f of omega t is the Fourier series expression of f of omega t will be equal to a naught upon by 2. This is the DC value plus this is the AC value, that is equal to summation of n is equal to 1 to infinite an cos n omega naught t plus n is equal to 1 to infinite bn sin n omega naught t. So these two are the AC component and one is the DC component. So any periodic function can be represented in the sum of or in the series of sine and cosine wave having different harmonics. Okay, now here a naught, an and bn, these are known as Fourier series coefficient. Okay, which can be easily found by one formula, that is a naught is equal to 1 upon pi. Check this, I think it will be 2 pi. A naught is equal to 1 upon 2 pi from 0 to 2 pi. This is the time period f of omega t into d omega t. What is this? A naught is nothing but area of f of omega t. Whatever the function is given, you have to find the integration is nothing but area. So area of f of omega t divided by time period will give me a naught. This is really important guys, try to understand what I am doing. At the end you will see very important concept related to this. Generally student skip the Fourier series because of this integration part. So I can write the integration part like area of f of omega t upon this is my time period. I can write like this. Okay. So whenever any function is given, just find the area of that function divide by time period, you will get a naught. That's all. There is nothing very big calculation is required. Right. In the same way, I can say an is equal to 2 upon 2 pi from 0 to 2 pi. This is my total time period f of omega t cos n omega naught t, where n is the harmonic number. So what I am doing here, see, this is my function, this is my first function and this is my second function having cos n omega naught t. So if I will multiply this first function with the second function and I will find the resultant waveform. Okay, after getting the resultant waveform, if I will find the area of that resultant waveform, that will give me the integration part. Right, and after getting the integration part, that is the area, if I will divide by time period, then I will get the value of an. Right, in the same way bn can be represented, that is equal to 2 upon 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of omega t sin n omega t d omega t. This is also the product of two function. Okay, so I can write area of product of two function upon time period. Time period here it is 2 pi. And if I will multiply this by 2, then I will get the bn. Are you getting this? So this is really important. That is what I want to explain here, because many students are getting confused how to find the integration, from where to where we have to take the limitation. So this lecture will sort it out each and every problem of the student. Just watch from start to end. Okay. So you got these all things, how we find the value of A0, AN, BN. Now the next question arises that in which case A0, AN, BN I will get. This is the question that must be in your mind. So let us take the first case, that is, let us take f of omega t having periodic waveform like this. From 0 to 2 pi it is half of triangle, or you can say right angle triangle, and from pi to 2 pi you are not getting anything. So this is the periodic waveform such like this, and I need to find the Fourier series expression. See, this is not the sinusoidal wave, so in order to represent this in a series of sine wave and cosine wave, what I will do? I will do the Fourier series, right? So I know the Fourier series expression, that is f of omega t, that is equal to this much. But let us find whether a naught is possible in this case or not. See, a naught is equal to what? 1 upon 2 pi from 0 to 2 pi f of omega t into d omega t, right? This is nothing but area under this waveform divided by time period, that I written here, area of f of omega t divided by time period. Now find the area of this, you will get non-zero value. Okay, this is having some area. So area is having non-zero value, that means a naught will be non-zero, means you will get a naught in this case. Similarly, an will be equal to, this will also be non-zero because this function is neither even or nor odd. Right. So a naught, an and bn, if you'll do this, then it will be non-zero value, means in this case I will get the value Fourier series expression in the sum of a naught, an and bn. Are you getting this? So case 1, if function is neither even nor odd, then in this case a naught will not equal to 0, an will also not equal to 0, and bn will not equal to 0. I am not going into detail of case 1 and case 2. Why? Because this is not relevant to the power electronics add in inverter part. So I am just writing a naught, an, bn will be non-zero. You will get these all three parameter. Now see the case 2. Case 2 is nothing but even function. Here even function is given. How you can say it is even function? You know, even function is equal to f of omega t is equal to f of minus omega t. If this condition satisfied, then it is known as even function. So see here, f of omega t, if you will explore in for t less than 0, then it will be something like this. So f of omega t will be equal to f of minus omega t, means this function is even function. So if function is even, then what will happen that I want to see. So first find the a naught. A naught is equal to 1 upon 2 pi from 0 to 2 pi f of omega t into d omega t, right? So see, this is from 0 to 2 pi. So this is my 0 and this is my 2 pi. So if I will find the area, then area will be equal to 0. So a naught I will get 0. Now find the value of an. An will be equal to, so if you will find this an, then you will get an will be not equal to 0. An you will get, that is the non-zero value. However, bn if you will find, then it will be equal to 0. I am not elaborating. Why? Because I am more interested in case 3. So just understand that if function will be even, then a naught will be 0 in power electronics. However, in mathematics, a naught you will get non-zero. An will also be non-zero. However, bn will be equal to 0. Right? So this even function you won't get in power electronics. That's why I'm not deriving these all things. Just for the sake of information, I am deriving this case 1 and case 2. Now see the case 3. That is really important from inverter point of view or from power electronics point of view. That is, if the function is odd function and it is something like this, and we know this is nothing but output voltage of the inverter. That's why I am interested in deriving these all things for this case 3. I am not interested in case 1 and case 2. I just elaborate just to understand the concept of how to find the a naught, an, bn. Now see the case 3. If function will be odd function, then what will be the value of a naught, an, bn, that we are going to see, and we will see each and everything graphically also, so that those guys who have fear of doing integration, they will came to know how to find the value of a naught, an, bn graphically. Okay, so let us understand what is the value of a naught here. A naught is nothing but 1 upon 2 pi from integration 0 to 2 pi f of omega t into d omega t. This is the value of a naught. This is nothing but area under this waveform divided by time period. And if you will see, from 0 to 2 pi, area is 0. Positive area is equal to negative area. So a naught will be equal to 0. Okay. Now understand this, how to find the value of an just by elaborating this waveform. So let us write the value of an, that is equal to 2 upon 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi f of omega t cos n omega t. How to find the value of an or a1 A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A7, how to find these all things graphically, that we are going to see. Of course, you can find this just by doing the integration, but why I am approaching graphically, I will let you know. So what I will do, let us find the value of A1 first. If the formula of An is this one, then the value of A1 will be equal to 2 upon 2 pi cos of omega t. If I will put n is equal to 1, then I will get the A1, right? Cos of omega t d omega t. Now what is happening here, just try to understand. I am going in depth in Fourier series. You will not get these all things in book. So just try to understand what I am doing. See here, function is f of omega t. So just draw the waveform of f of omega t like this. So this is my f of omega t. Now this f of omega t is getting multiplied by cos of omega t. This is my time axis. This is my omega t axis, right? So if I will multiply this f of omega t with cos of omega t and both are having same time period, means how will I draw the cos of omega t? Draw the waveform of cos of omega t. The waveform of cos of omega t will be something like this. Is it fine? I am not bothering about the peak value. Here cos of omega t is taken, so the peak value will be 1 only. So I am not bothering which one will be higher. I am not bothering about. I am just multiplying f of omega t with cos of omega t. Now multiply these two waveform, then the resultant waveform will look like this. Just understand this. If you will understand this, then you will not get any problem in deriving any kind of Fourier series expression in power electronics. So see here, this is at peak and this is also at peak. So multiply peak multiplied by peak, you will get the peak value. And this is at zero. Here cos of omega t is zero and this is VDC. So VDC multiplied by zero will give me zero. So overall, the resultant waveform will be something like this. This is peak value. It is going, it is following cos only, having peak value increases. And this is, this will be at zero here. Now see, from pi by 2, this is my pi by 2. From pi by 2 to pi, this is plus VDC, right? But cos omega t is negative. So positive multiplied by negative will give me the negative value. So how the waveform will look like from pi by 2 to pi, it will be negative. And it will follow the cos of omega t only, right? It is something like this. Now see, from pi to 2 pi, minus VDC multiplied by minus of cos omega t will give me the plus of cos omega t. So from pi to 3 pi by 2, again I will get the positive value. Okay, just multiply these two waveform, you will understand what I am doing. Now see, from 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi, cos omega t is in plus and this is minus VDC. So minus VDC multiplied by plus cos omega t will give me minus only. It is something like this. So this is my resultant waveform of these two function, f of omega t into cos omega t, right? So I got the product of these two waveform. And if I will find the integration, integration is nothing but area. If you will find the area of this waveform, then overall positive area will cancel out by negative area. So what you will get? The area of this waveform will be equal to zero. Are you getting this? This is really important. So A1 will be equal to zero. If your area will be zero, then what is the value of A1? The value of A1 will be equal to 0. In the same way, I can find the A2 just by writing here cos 2 omega t. So draw the waveform of cos 2 omega t and multiply with this f of omega t. Again, you will get the value of A2 that is equal to 0. Are you getting this? Similarly, A3 will be also equal to 0. A4 will be also equal to 0. So what is the conclusion? Conclusion is, if the function is odd, then the value of An will be equal to 0. This is really important. In any book, if you will see, then they are just finding the integration part just by taking the integration and they are proving that this is 0. But I am not finding just by doing the integration. I am finding just by drawing the multiplication of two waveform and finding the area. If area will be 0, then of course An will be 0. Right? So conclusion is, if the function will be odd, then the value of An will be equal to 0. Now I think that you have understood this concept. In the same way, let us try to find the value of Bn. What will be the value of Bn? Okay, so what is the formula of Bn? Same procedure I will apply in order to find the Bn and see whether Bn is non-zero or zero. So in order to prove this, let us try to find the value of B1 first. So this is my waveform of f of omega t, which is an odd function, that is the square wave. And if I will multiply this with sine omega t and I will integrate, means if I will find the area of these two product of these two function, then I will get the b1. Okay, so first I will multiply these two function and I will find the resultant function, same like what we do for an. So here sine omega t is, will look like this, and f of omega t is like this. So see, from 0 to pi, sine is also positive and it is also plus VDC. So overall, if I will multiply these two, then I will get the sine value only, but the peak value increase. So I am not bothering about what is the magnitude. I don't know. Just understand, if I will multiply these two waveform, then overall the resultant waveform will look like this, right? From pi to 2 pi c, sine is also negative and this is also minus VDC. Are you getting this? So minus multiplied by minus will give me plus resultant, right? So from pi to 2 pi also, the resultant of these two function will be positive only. Now understand the concept. This is my pi, this is my 2 pi. What is this? This is my output of full wave rectifier. Are you getting this? Now find the integration of this waveform. So integration is nothing but area. So if I will find the area of this function from 0 to pi and from pi to 2 pi, that will give me the area of overall function, and this is non-zero, right? So if this is non-zero, means definitely b1 I will get, that will be non-zero. So if function will be odd, then in that case bn will be not equal to 0. Now you understand graphically how to find the Fourier series. So this is really important. Now you understood how to find the Fourier series expression. I have just explained you, I have just proved you by a graphical method. And I am sure that you will not get this kind of concept in Bhimrao or any kind of book or any coaching material. So this is really important. This lecture is really important. Please recommend this lecture to your friends or juniors so that they can also get benefit from this concept. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is, if function will be odd, then I will get bn non-zero, however a0 and an will be zero. Now let us understand one more concept. Definitely this concept will blow your mind. Let us try to understand. I can easily find the value of b1 after multiplying these two. So what is the value of b1? B1 will be equal to from 2 upon 2 pi. I can divide in two parts. The integration from 0 to pi, it is equal to f of omega t multiplied by sine omega t plus 2 upon 2 pi. From pi to 2 pi also, it will be equal to f of omega t into sine of omega t into d omega t. I can write like this. If I need to find the value of b1, then I can easily find just by putting the limit from 0 to pi and from pi to 2 pi and integrating, I will get the b1. Now understand this concept. This is really important. See here, whatever the area I am getting from 0 to pi, that is equal from pi to 2 pi also. So this area and this area are equal. So I can say that this value and this value both are equal. I can say this. So why to integrate from pi to 2 pi? Why I will make the bulky calculation like this? I don't need to make the bulky calculation. What I will do, in order to find the b1 or bn, what I will do? B1 will be equal to, just I will do, I will integrate from 0 to pi and I will multiply these two function f of omega t multiplied by sine of omega t into d omega t. And this is my area under this waveform from 0 to pi. Now from pi to 2 pi also the area will remain same. So I will multiply this by 2. This is really important, guys. This will reduce your calculation. In most of the book you will see they are integrating from 0 to pi, again from pi to 2 pi. Why to integrate from pi to 2 pi? If I know that area will be equal, then I will integrate from 0 to pi only and I will multiply this by 2. Is it fine? So in order to find the value of bn, what is the new formula? The new formula will be equal to bn is equal to, now the question is, in which case I will multiply this by 2 and in which case I will get the equal area from pi to 2 pi and from 0 to pi? That is also important. We cannot do for any kind of function. It may be different for other function. Let us take some function f of omega t, something like this. If f of omega t will be something like this, then I can't do like this. Right, I cannot multiply this by 2. The function from 0 to pi and from pi to 2 pi, it will remain as it is, then only I can multiply this by 2. So what is the question? The question is, in which type of waveform this is possible? So this formula is possible only the function is half wave symmetry. If the function is half wave symmetry, then I can reduce the calculation just by integrating for half time period. I don't need to integrate for full cycle. It will increase my calculation, also it will increase my time. So what I will do, I will just check if the function is half wave symmetry, then I will just find from for half cycle and I will multiply this by 2. Got it? So this is the conclusion. Now the next question is, what is half wave symmetry? That is also I need to make you understand what is half wave symmetry. So half wave symmetry is known as, if the function is something like this and this is my odd function. Now the condition of half wave symmetry is, if f of theta, let us say this is my theta angle and this is my pi plus theta. So if f of theta is equal to minus of f of pi plus theta, if this condition is true, then that kind of function is known as half wave symmetry. Okay, means this function is half wave symmetry. Is it fine? That's why I have got the same area. If the function will be half wave symmetry, then I can multiply this by 2 and I will integrate only for half cycle. So see here, if function will be odd function first and it is half wave symmetry, then no need to integrate for full cycle. Just write bn is equal to 2 upon 2 pi and integrate for till pi only, no need to integrate for 2 pi, and write f of omega t into sine of n omega t d omega t and multiply this equation with 2. That will give you the bn. So what is the benefit of just finding half wave symmetry? If you know that this function is half wave symmetry, then it will reduce your calculation. Are you getting this? So this is really important. First check whether the function is odd function or not. If the function is odd function, then directly you can say a naught is equal to an is equal to 0 and only bn will exist. Okay. Now in order to find the bn, check whether this function is half wave symmetry or not. If the function is half wave symmetry, then just apply this formula, it will reduce your calculation. Okay. Now let us try to understand one more concept that I am going to explain you here. I am interested in finding the value of, see, I have found the value of V1. Now I am interested in finding the value of B2. Okay, so what is the value of B2? See, the value of B2 will be equal to 2 upon 2 pi, integration from 0 to 2 pi, f of omega t multiplied by sine 2 omega t. Why 2? Because I am interested in finding the value of B2. Okay, so you can find the value of B2 just by integration, but I am not interested in finding the value of B2 by integration. What I will do, I will go with the waveform. So let us find the product of these two functions. How the sine 2 omega t will look like? It is having a double the frequency of this f of omega t. So sine 2 omega t will be somehow here. It will look like this. Okay. Now multiply these two waveforms and see what I am getting. So if I will multiply these two waveform, then it will look like this. This is my output waveform of these two function. After getting multiplied, the function will look like this. Now see what is the conclusion here. If you will find the integration of these two function, integration is nothing but area. So see here, this is my positive area and this is my negative area. So overall, positive area are equal to negative area. So I can say the value of B2 will be equal to 0. Because here area I am getting, that is equal to 0. Got it? So what is the conclusion? If you will find the value of B4, same as like this, again you will get 0. If you will find the value of B6, again it will be equal to 0, just by drawing the waveform. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is, half wave symmetry does not have even harmonics. This is the conclusion. Even harmonics will be equal to 0. Got it? So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is, if the function is odd function and it is half wave symmetry, then it will be, the Fourier series expression will be equal to n is equal to 1, 3, 5. It will not have any even harmonics. It is only odd harmonics and it is equal to bn sine n omega naught t. Now if it is half wave symmetry, then I can easily find the value of bn, that is equal to 2 upon 2 pi. I will not integrate from 0 to 2 pi. I will integrate only from 0 to pi. And it is f of omega t multiplied by sine n omega t into d omega t, and I will get the resultant of these two, and I will multiply this by 2. So it will give me the overall value of bn. No need to integrate till 2 pi. Why to increase the calculation, right? So in this way we can reduce the calculation. Let us find quickly how it look like. So I can write just by 4 upon 2 pi, multiply this by 2 here, 4 upon 2 pi, it will be from 0 to pi, and from 0 to pi it is equal to VDC multiplied by sine of n omega t into d omega t. See how much calculation is reduced. So finally it will be equal to 2 VDC upon pi n into 1 minus cos n pi. This is my value of bn, right? Now take n is equal to 1. If you will take n is equal to 1, 3, 5, then it will be equal to 4 VDC upon pi n. For n is equal to 1, 3, 5, 7. Means it is containing odd harmonics. Now if you will take n is equal to 2, then cos 2 n, cos 2 pi, cos 4 pi, cos 6 pi, it is equal to 1 only. So 1 minus 1 will give you 0. So the value of bn you will get only for odd harmonics, not for even harmonics. So by integration also, I am getting the same thing what I got graphically. Got it? So overall Fourier series expression will look like this. So see how much the calculation is getting reduced just by understanding this concept that if the function is half wave symmetry, then no need to integrate for full cycle, just integrate for half cycle. Now let us understand one more concept that will reduce some more calculation, that is quarter wave symmetry. So what is the condition for having a function that is quarter wave symmetry? If f of 90 plus theta is equal to f of 90 minus theta, and if f of 270 plus theta is equal to f of 270 minus theta. If these two conditions satisfied, then that function is known as quarter wave symmetry. Okay, so condition of getting quarter wave symmetry is these two. Also you can say that the function must be half wave symmetry in order to get the quarter wave symmetry. Means if the function is half wave symmetry, then only it is possible that we will get the quarter wave symmetry. Otherwise it is not possible. Means we cannot say like that if the function is quarter wave symmetry and it is not half wave symmetry. It is not possible. Okay. See here, this is also half wave symmetry. Let us take another function. This is the half wave symmetry. Of course I am getting the half wave symmetry. F of theta is equal to minus of f of pi plus theta. This is my pi and this is my 2 pi. So this is my half wave symmetry. Now check the quarter wave symmetry. So in order to check the quarter wave symmetry, see at 90 degree and 270 degree. Okay. So f of 90 plus theta means if I will move here, and f of 90 minus theta if I will move here, then I will get the same value. Similarly, f of 270 plus theta and f of 270 minus theta will have same value. So this is also quarter wave symmetry. Now see the second function. Let us take one more function just to understand whether it is half wave symmetry or quarter wave symmetry or not. See this function. This is my second function. Okay. Check whether this is half wave symmetry or not. Half wave symmetry says f of theta must be equal to minus of f of pi plus theta. So if I will take this, this is my theta and this is my pi plus theta. So you can see f of theta is having minus of f of pi plus theta, means it is half wave symmetry. Now check the quarter wave symmetry. Quarter wave symmetry, what you have to do, just see at 90 degree. This is my 90 degree and this is my 270 degree. So f of 90 plus theta is not equal to f of 90 minus theta. Here see, f of 90 plus theta is not equal to f of 90 minus theta. Why? See, if I will take the theta nearer to 90 degree, then I am getting the VDC. But if I will take the 90 minus theta here, then I am not getting VDC. So overall, this is not the quarter wave symmetry, but it is half wave symmetry. Got it? So what I can conclude, the conclusion will be, every quarter wave symmetry is half wave symmetry, but converse is not true. Okay? So take this in your notes, that every quarter wave symmetry, if the function is quarter wave symmetry, then no need to check for half wave symmetry. It will be half wave symmetry, because the condition of quarter wave symmetry is the function must be half wave symmetry. Now let us try to understand what will happen to the Fourier series expression if the function will be quarter wave symmetry. I know this is odd function. Also, this is half wave symmetry. I know this. Now I have to check the quarter wave symmetry, means this is also quarter wave symmetry. I can check. Here f of 90 plus theta is equal to f of 90 minus theta. Also f of 270 plus theta is equal to f of 270 minus theta. Means Fourier series expression of this function will be v naught of t, that is equal to only odd harmonics will present because it is half wave symmetry. So summation of n is equal to 135 to infinite bn sin n omega naught t. A naught and an will be equal to 0, that we see previously. Now I need to find the value of bn in quarter wave symmetry. So just try to understand this concept. First first find the value of b1. So these all things I did previously. So let me write the resultant waveform quickly. Now what will happen if the function is quarter wave symmetry? I already explained you that this function is quarter wave symmetry. Then see the here what is happening. See from 0 to pi by 2. From 0 to pi by 2, the area will be something like this. Okay. And this area will be equal to having area from pi by 2 to pi also. And this area are equal in here from pi to 3 pi by 2 also. And this area are equal from 3 pi by 2 to pi also. To pi also. Right? So what is the benefit of function having quarter wave symmetry? If the function is having quarter wave symmetry, then what I will do? I will just integrate up to pi by 2. Means I will integrate only quarter wave and I will multiply this by 4. Then I will get the value of b1. So what is the value of b1? The value of b1 will be equal to 2 upon 2 pi from 0 to pi by 2, not 2 pi, from 0 to pi by 2. This is my area under this shaded region from 0 to pi by 2. I am integrating only from 0 to pi by 2. And if I will multiply this by 4, then I will get the area of resultant waveform. Got it? So this is the benefit of quarter wave symmetry. The benefit of half wave symmetry that we saw previously, that is you have to integrate up to half cycle, but the benefit of quarter wave symmetry is that you have to integrate only till quarter cycle, means you have to integrate from 0 to pi by 2 only. So this is also reducing calculation. So it is also reducing calculation, and this is reducing calculation more. So this is the benefit of having the function quarter wave symmetry. 4 vdc upon pi, just integrate from 0 to pi by 2 into 1 minus cos pi by 2, that is equal to 4 vdc upon pi. Got it? So what is the value of b1? The b1 will be equal to 4 vdc upon pi. Now if you found the b1, then bn will be equal to just divide by n, 4 vdc upon n pi, that is equal to bn. So see how I have reduced the calculation in order to find the Fourier series expression or Fourier series coefficient. If you understood half wave symmetry, quarter wave symmetry, then the calculation will become very easy. Got it? So this is the advantage of this lecture. I explained each and every point how to check whether it is half wave symmetry and quarter wave symmetry. Now I need to explain one more thing. I am saying that the function is quarter wave symmetry. Okay. And I am telling you that plot the waveform for full cycle, then you can easily plot it. If you know that the function is quarter wave symmetry, then you can plot the waveform for full cycle also. Let us try to plot it. See what the question I am asking. I am asking like, I have given you the waveform only till quarter cycle, that is 90 degree. And I am saying that this function is quarter wave symmetry. Now what you have to do, you have to draw the waveform for full cycle. So how will you draw? See, I already know that this function is quarter wave symmetry, means this is symmetrical about 90 degree. This is my 90 degree, means f of 90 minus theta must be equal to f of 90 plus theta. So this is my f of 90 plus theta up to pi. Let us say this is my pi. Okay. So waveform will look like this. Now, if the function is quarter wave symmetry, means it will be half wave symmetry. That is true. So half wave symmetry means if I know the half wave cycle, then the next cycle will be like this, because the condition of half wave symmetry is f of theta must be equal to minus of f of pi plus theta. So if I need to draw the waveform of f of minus of pi plus theta, f of theta I already know, so minus of f of pi plus theta will look like something like this. So if I know that the function is quarter wave symmetry, and second, the waveform is given till 90 degree only, then I can easily plot for full cycle. So this is my function, actual function for full cycle. Okay. See the next and try to draw the waveform of this. Suppose I am giving you the waveform something like this, and I am saying you that this is the quarter wave symmetry. It is given in the question that this function is, this waveform is quarter wave symmetry. Now you need to plot for full cycle. So how will you plot? Let us plot first what is the given. From 0 to 90, it is something like this. This is my 90 degree. Now I need to plot for full cycle, and I know that this function is quarter wave symmetry. So f of 90 plus theta must be equal to f of 90 minus theta. So f of 90 minus theta is something like this, means f of 90 plus theta will be something like this. Again, it will go above and it will be something like this. This is my pi. Now I know that this is quarter wave symmetry, means this must be half wave symmetry. I have plotted the waveform for half cycle, and I know that this is half wave symmetry. Then I can easily draw the waveform for full cycle also. This is my waveform of full cycle. This is my 2 pi and this is my 3 pi by 2, that is 270 degree. So this is the waveform I plotted for full cycle, and this is the final waveform of f of omega t. So what I am trying to say, that if you know that the function is quarter wave symmetry or the function is half wave symmetry, then you can easily plot the waveform till 2 pi. That is what I am saying. So let us try to conclude what we saw in this lecture. So conclusion is, whenever you get any function, then first check whether that function is half wave symmetry or quarter wave symmetry or not. Okay. If the function is odd function and half wave symmetry, then a naught and an, of course, it will be zero, and only bn will exist with odd harmonics, as we know that half wave symmetry will not have even harmonics, and you can easily find bn, that is equal to 2 upon 2 pi from 0 to pi only, no need to check till 2 pi, integrate from 0 to pi and multiply it by 2, that we have discussed. Now if function is odd plus quarter wave symmetry, so if the function is quarter wave symmetry, then you need to integrate up to pi by 2 only and multiply it by 4. So this will reduce your calculation, and overall Fourier series expression of complete waveform will be equal to f of omega t, this much bn sin n omega naught t, and only odd harmonics will present. So this is the conclusion of this introduction to Fourier series in PWM. Now I am pretty much sure that you understood each and every concept, how to find these all things, and first check whether this is half wave symmetry and quarter wave symmetry, and based on that you can easily reduce your calculation. So whatever we have studied in this lecture, let us try to take one homework from this lecture. Draw the waveform for full cycle function is quarter wave symmetry, means this function is quarter wave symmetry, and you need to draw the waveform for full cycle. And I know you can't comment this, so you can't comment this waveform in YouTube comment. So what you can do, you can just post it in our Facebook group, this question number one, in order to check whether you have made the waveform correct or not. Question number two, you need to put the answer in YouTube comment. Okay, what the question number two said? Question number two said that check half wave symmetry and quarter wave symmetry, means whether this 2a is half wave symmetry or quarter wave symmetry, and 2b is half wave symmetry or quarter wave symmetry or not. Slope is same. Okay, so check this and write down the answer of this question number 2a and 2b in YouTube comment. I will reply whether this is correct or not. And for this, you can post in the Facebook group and tag me. I will verify you whether you have made the waveform for full cycle correct or not. Got it? So if you guys understood the concept, then please like this video and share these all concept with your friends and juniors. For doubt solving, you can join our Facebook group.